I am Mohammad Farhan Jahangir, and today I will be talking about information modeling for leveraging digital twin at a building level. You know, according to a national human activity pattern survey, we humans spend 90% of our time inside the building. So it is important to make these buildings more sustainable and more healthier. This is where the concept of digital twins comes in, which in terms of buildings is a digital replica of a building in which the automatic flow of information from the building to the digital model and from the digital model back to the building. When I started working with the information modeling for the buildings, I remember in my undergraduate days, we have a professor who normally gives us the assignment of 10 questions, and she divides that assignment into 3 to 4 parts. And each part consists of some variables, let's say X, Y, and Z. Now, she instructs us to use X as our roll number, and after solving the part one, the solution will be used as Y, variable Y for next part, and similarly, subsequently, we find the value of Z to solve the last part. So in a way, she joined or integrated all the assignment together that to get at the end of assignment, we have to solve other two parts. Whenever I see information modeling for digital twin, I remember that assignment because it is, in a way, all connected together. From buildings, we get the information through different sensors, through different devices that goes into a coordinator, into digital model, that assemble that data, that arrange, organize that data, and that data goes into different simulation models, which are required to run some scenarios. Like, for example, let's take the scenario of evacuation, emergency evacuation from the building in case of earthquake. So to find the emergency evacuation routes for the earthquake analysis, there is no single simulator that can run that analysis. So we need to integrate multiple simulators. And in building industry, we don't have a common platform, a common vocabulary that can integrate those simulations. So for that, we introduced the concept of building simulation identity cards that helps to integrate these simulation models. Now, once we have the simulation run, now the non-structural and structural component of the building will be updated. But right now, that digital model won't know that this simulation updated the digital model. So there must be something that tells that this model is updated, and the new coming simulation will use that updated model. So for that, we are working on the dynamic data modeling within Beam framework, which will update those structural and non-structural data within that digital model, which will be used for the other simulation models. And that results from the simulation model will go again to the coordinator, and that will go again back to the building in form of alarms and different updates in the structural and non-structural component. Thank you.